Hey guys, so today we're gonna be building an electric fidget spinner. Things that you're gonna need is a motor, a battery, a switch, ball bearing, and any piece of wood or a circuit board in this case would be fine. And some other tools that you're gonna need are hot glue gun, some pliers, and some electric tape or duct tape will be fine. So the first thing what you're gonna do is get your piece of wood or circuit board in this case and try and measure the diameter of your motor. And then try and drill a hole into it and make the motor fit into it. Once you've done that, get your switch and you see how those legs standing outside. So, yeah, you're gonna get your pliers. And be careful not to break them, but just bend them slightly so they're all sticking outwards. And this switch needs to be real small so it fits in between a fidget spinner. Once you've done that, keep that aside. I get the black wire from the battery. I got this battery off a helicopter, so one of the toy helicopters that was broken. So what you want to do after that is connect the black wire from the motor, and the black wire to the battery. Twist that around. Once you're done that, you can either solder it or just hot glue it if you do not have a soldering iron. That you keep the two wires connected. So once you've done that, let it dry. And what you want to do is get the red wire and get one leg of the switch and then twist it around. Those two together. Once you've done that, glue that to. Dry for some time. And I can see they both are dried up. So let's get on with the next step. So what you want to do after that is to connect these two legs together. See that when I press the button, the motor starts to spin. So, yeah. around that, connect them together. Get the glue gun again. Put it on top. Now let that dry. Once that's done, what you want to do is test it out. So just press the button and see if the motor spins. When you're doing this at home, you should probably feel the motor spin. Though you can't see, you could probably hear it. So yeah, so my one's working. So yeah, now you can keep that aside. Second step we're going to do is get the circuit board or the piece of wood and find a plate and try and center this. Center the bearing down. Okay, I'll find a spot for where the bearing's gonna go. So I'm gonna put it on this side. Before that, what you're meant to do is get a bit of glue, hot glue, and just put it on the side. That side a little bit. That side a little bit. And let that dry. So this is gonna allow the bearings to sit without touching the center circle. After putting glue on this, what you're meant to do is get the motor, see if it fits in between, and check the ball bearing. And if you have a free spinning bearing, that's good. If it's free and not touching the bottom of the shipboard, that's good. Or a piece of wood that you're gonna be using. After that, what you're gonna try and do is try and tidy this wire up. So you're going to twist it around. So you're gonna be twisting it around and putting it around the motor. Like that, and then get some tape and tape it down. The wire, and then you can just cut the piece, the extra bit of tape. So yeah, just check if it's working, and it is, and then continue. What you're gonna do next is the battery down and then glue the battery to the motor. Once you've done that, button down, that's vibrating, and then glue the button. To the battery. After gluing the switch down and letting it dry, you want to tidy up the red wire, put it inside, get some tape, and tape all that down. looks nice and clean. And test down once again. Mine looks like it's working pretty good. So then what you want to do is get the circuit board, place it on top, glue that down. That dry, and once the glue is dry, test it out. There you go, mine's pretty good. See that spin? So all you want to do after this is get the bearing and just place it over that. So once you finish putting the side block, you want to glue it down using the centerpiece there, and then here we go. It's pretty fast, like you can see it.